Okay, Bonanza Pete, Miss Shelley here. What we're doing, we're getting ready to apply the side onto a concert size cherry ukulele. Anyhow, what we'll do, we'll go through here. First thing, of course, we have to do is spread some glue on. So we'll get started on that. Get a glue bottle that's open. Always something. This morning I got out here and first thing that happened was the motor went on my table saw. So there, got a piece out of it. So now I think we're ready to rock and roll. What I have to do is spread a good bead all the way around the edge. Do a double layout. And you can maybe see that a little bit over the head here. You want enough glue for good coverage, but not so much that it runs all over the inside of it. Shelly's going to be my assistant today. She tightens the hair curlers on the ukulele. You know what hair curlers are, right? Shelly will show you.
Just like the old-fashioned foam rollers, only they got a rod in the middle.
Now I have test fit this already and it went in snugly, which is what we want, but not so snug that it tears the deal apart. I've got an X on the back of here and an X on this, so then this is the way we start. Except, good thing I have my assistant here. Gotta spread that glue out. So we have a nice surface of it. Again, enough glue that it bonds, but not that we get a whole lot of run out. Once this is glued up and it's in the clamps, it'll have to sit in the clamps about a half hour for the glue to set. Then we can take it out and trim the edges. We go a little bit different than what a lot of people do. I actually build my top and bottom, assemble them, and then apply the sides. So the kerfing is actually built right into the top and bottom. There we go, we got a nice glue surface all around. Set that down, being careful not to get glue on the what will be the finished surface. I need you to move that styrofoam out of there, Shelly.
Well, there's glue.
Just take it out of there. Okay. It's a two-person job, one to push it over, wheel it over.
It was used for a berry raft, so it's wider.
Now we work our way around the outside edge, another one right there. This side has been clamped and in a mold for about 24 hours. So it's pretty well set to size. It's just final fitting it onto the framework. Okay, get me another one right about in, back a little bit there. What we do is we get these anchored and then we'll come back and add a whole bunch more to them. Okay, right there in the corner. Piece of tape. Where the two halves meet, I put tape and then run a block. Put the drill facing forward.
Works better.
I haven't even heard any swearing yet. That does sometimes happen. But mainly by Miss Shelley. These were clamps that we made using a hole saw on our drill press, and just quarter inch bolts.
Pretty standard fare for luthiers.
You mean I didn't invent this?
No, I don't think so. No sense in reinventing the wheel entirely.
From here on out, it goes pretty fast.
I'm sorry. Flipped her backwards.
Once it sets, we're able to shape it, do the final sanding. Put it in the spray booth, finish it, attach the neck. One more.
A few extra because this is only a concert.
There it is. glued up, ready to dry. Okay.
How do you turn this one off?